In this video, we will find the slope of a line given the graph. The slope is a number which is a measure of the steepness or slant of a line. There are four types of slopes. We will read our graph, looking at the graph as it goes from left to right. If the line goes uphill from left to right, we have a positive slope. If the line goes downhill from left to right, it is a negative slope. A perfectly horizontal line has a slope of zero. A perfectly vertical line is said to have an undefined slope. Determine whether the slope of each line is positive, negative, zero, or undefined. Review what we have learned from the last slide. In number one, we are going uphill from left to right. When we go uphill from left to right, we have a positive slope. So for number one, the slope is positive. For number two, we have a perfectly horizontal line. A perfectly horizontal line has a slope of zero. For number three, we can see we are going downhill from left to right. When the line goes downhill from left to right, we have a negative slope. So for number three, our slope is negative. For number four, the line is perfectly vertical. When we have a perfectly vertical line, we say the slope is undefined. In the last exercise, we just were concerned whether the slope was positive or negative. Now we are going to determine the number of the slope. To calculate the number of the slope, we're going to use rise over run, which is the vertical distance, the up or down distance, divided by the horizontal distance. We write it as a ratio. Rise over run. The first thing we are going to do is identify two points on the line. You can see on the graph we have point A and point B. We could pick any two points, but we want to pick points that fall on the crosshairs of the graph. These are points that will have integer coordinates. So we could have picked this point that crosses the y-axis here because that falls on the crosshairs of the graph. But we wouldn't want to pick a point right here because that would not have integers as its x and y values. First, we're going to start at the leftmost point, point A, we'll call that. Then we're going to determine the rise needed to get to the other point. So we draw a line up to the y value of B. So this is our rise. If we're going up, it's positive. If we're going down, it is negative. So here our rise is 1, 2, positive 2. Next, we will determine the run needed to get to the other point. So from here, we're going to draw a line to get to B. So that will be our run. And our run is 1, 2, 3, and because we're going to the right, that's positive 3. So for this, our rise is 2, and our run is 3. So we would write our slope as 2 over 3, or 2/3 would be the slope of this line. We can also check that this line is going uphill from left to right, and therefore, the number we get for the slope should be positive. Determine the slope of each line. We're not just going to determine if we have a positive or a negative slope, but the actual number of the slope. We can see that number one is going uphill from left to right, so this is a positive slope, and number two is going downhill from left to right, so that's a negative slope. But now we're going to determine what the number of the slope is. So first, we will pick two points that fall on the crosshairs of the graph that would have integer points. Here is our point A, and here is our point B. We are going to determine our rise and our run. So from point A, we're going to draw a line going up until we hit the y value that point B is on, and then that distance is our rise. We count 1, 2, 3. So our rise is 3. Then we will draw a line over to point B, and that is our run. And that is a distance of 1. So our rise over run is 3 over 1. And our line is going uphill from left to right, so this should be a positive slope. We can simplify 3 over 1, because 3 divided by 1 is 3. In problem 2, we will pick two points that fall on the crosshairs of the graph that would have integer values for their coordinates. We're going to determine the rise over the run. We start at point A, and we draw a line to the y value of point B, perfectly vertically. The distance for the rise is 1. We're going downhill, so it's negative 1. Then we'll draw a line horizontally for our run. The run is 1, 2. We went to the right, so that's positive 2. So our rise is negative 1, and our run is 2. So we could say that our slope is negative 1/2. Remember, slope is the rise over the run, the vertical distance, the up and down distance, divided by the horizontal distance, the right or left distance. Determine the slopes of each line. Remember that a perfectly horizontal line has a slope of 0, and a perfectly vertical line has a slope that's called undefined. In number 3, our slope is perfectly vertical. This slope is undefined. In number 4, we have a perfectly horizontal line. So for this slope, our slope is 0.